Hello and happy day. Have you reminded yourself to slow down today, to reduce the noise, to listen? My name is Igor, SF Walker, and I'm here to remind people to slow down, to reduce the noise, to walk their lives into a natural flow. Welcome back to the Book of the Week series. Every week, as I read another amazing title, I share it with the world. And today, we look at The Selfish Gene by Richard Dawkins. The argument of this book is that we and all other animals are machines created by our genes. Like successful gangsters, our genes have survived, in some cases for millions of years. In a highly competitive world, this entitles us to expect certain qualities in our genes. And Dawkins will argue that a predominant quality to be expected in a successful gene is ruthless selfishness. It goes even further, making the universal love and the welfare of the species as a whole as concepts that simply do not make evolutionary sense. So let us try and teach generosity and altruism because we're born selfish. Let us understand what our own selfish genes are up to because we may then at least have the chance to upset their designs, something that no other species has truly aspired to do. Among animals, man is uniquely dominated by culture, by influences learned and handed down. Where do you stand in the debate over nature versus nurture as determinants of human attributes? Curiously, peacetime appeals for individuals to make some small sacrifices in rate at which they increase their standards of living seem to be less effective than the wartime appeals for individuals to lay down their lives. What Dawkins argues is that the fundamental unit of selection, and therefore of self-interest, is not the species or the group, nor even strictly the individual. It is the gene, the unit of heredity. An individual body seems discrete enough while it lasts, but how often is that? Each individual is unique. You cannot get evolution by selecting between entities when there's only one copy of each entity. Sexual reproduction is not replication. Just as population is contaminated by other populations, so is an individual's posterity contaminated by that of his sexual partner. Your children are only half you. Your grandchildren are only quarter you. In a few generations, the most you can hope for is a large number of descendants, each of whom bears only a tiny portion of you, a few genes, even if a few of them do bear your last name as well. We shall continue to treat the individual as the selfish machine, programmed to do whatever is best for its genes as a whole. This is the language of convenience. The fundamental unit of selection is not the species, nor the group, nor even the strictly the individual. It is the gene. The individual is too large and too temporary of a genetic unit. Is the assumption that the important thing in evolution is the good of the species or the group, rather than the good of the individual or the gene, erroneous? The more clearly we understand the selfishness of the genetic process, the more qualified we shall be to teach the merits of generosity and cooperativeness and all else that works for the common good. If you have enjoyed this video, please do like it and share it with the world. Subscribe to my channel, and you can find a direct link to this book in the description below. So get it and read. Thank you. Love and respect.